Amen. Good morning. Ayan, let's all settle down na. Ayan, praise God. How sweet it is to be in the presence of God. Amen. It's so good to worship the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Now, I just also want to acknowledge all our viewers. Sa Zoom, we are United Nations. We are all over the world. So, praise God. Welcome po for today. Now, we are now in the part 2 of our series. Praise God. So just a week ago, we were discussing about the ACCI core values. So sino pang nakakaalala nun? Amen! Amen! Praise God! So now this series is part of this year's challenge that no ACCI members would be ignorant of God's word. Amen? Amen? Now, the anchor verse for this series is from Romans 8, 28 to 29. The very famous Romans 8, 28 to 29. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. For those God foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son, that He might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. Grabe, no? We are predestined to be Christ-like. Well, that's the original plan of God until sin came in. But today, we will know once again how to live according to the path that God has chosen for us. Amen? Are you all excited? Amen. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, I'm blessed you're here. Amen. And the title for our preaching for today is, Wait, am I really born again? Anong Tagalog nun? Teka, born again na nga ba ako? And our anchor verse is coming from John 4 verse 24. For God is spirit, so those who worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Now, the title, Born Again, reminds me of way back in high school. My good friend invited me. Sabi niya, Ate Yem, can I invite you to church? So I said, anong church ba yan? And anong araw? So sabi niya, she said, actually it's on Sunday and it's a born again church. So when she said that, two things came to my mind. The day of worship and the church denomination. Why? I was born and raised in an Adventist community. So we go to church every Saturday. We keep the Sabbath day during Saturday. And as well, the type of worship that we observe is a very solemn worship. So nung sinabi niya yon, I said, I have to say no because this is exactly an opposite of the worship that I grew up with. So yun yung, that's what I know before what it is being born again. Before, being born again for me means observing a specific worship on a specific day or observing a type of worship. So that's how I understand it before. Now today, we will dig deeper what it really means to be born again. Amen? But before that, let's pray first. Let's pray. Yes, hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, Lord, for your presence today. So magnificent, oh God. Thank you, Lord, for giving us another day to breathe, to have this life that sometimes we take for granted. And Lord, thank you once again for your goodness never fail. Lord, anoint your servant today, O God. Holy Spirit, take charge. Take full control, Lord God, not based on what I know, not based on what I know is of right and wrong, but rather, Lord, may your fresh revelation, Lord God, be within today, Lord God. We welcome you, Holy Spirit, in this place. Lord, we ask, Father God, for a submissive heart. For each and every one of us, submissive heart, submissive mind, Lord God. Open, Lord, the eyes and ears, Lord God, of everybody today. And enter, Lord God. Maraming salamat, Lord. And forgive us as well, Father, for the things that we have committed, the things, the thought that is not pleasing in your sight, in your eyes. Or if nakasakit kami ng kapwa, Lord God, patawarin niyo po kami, Panginoon. Give us a clean hands and a pure heart, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So our scripture reading for today is from John 4, verse 1 to 26. Now, I know most of you have heard already the story of the Samaritan woman. Maybe you've heard about it, maybe you know about it already, but it's always a blessing to hear the message of God, to read the Bible as a family. Amen? Now, the writer of our story for today is John the Beloved, so he is also one of the disciples of Jesus Christ. Now, what's his goal? Why he wrote John, or the book of John? Now, his goal is so that we may believe in the name of Jesus, being the Messiah, the Son of God, and in believing, we may have life. That is also found in John 20, verse 31. Now, the speaker is Jesus Christ, and the audience is the Samaritan woman. So, sa kanila iikot yung story natin today. Amen? Are you all excited? Yes. Amen! So, let's read together. Now, Jesus learned that the Pharisees had heard that he was gaining and baptizing more disciples than John. Although, in fact, it was not Jesus who baptized, but his disciples. So he left Judea and went back once more to Galilee. Now he had to go through Samaria. So he came to a town in Samaria called Sychar, near the plot of ground Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, and Jesus, tired as he was from the journey, sat down by the well. It was about noon. When a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" His disciples had gone into the town to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "You are a Jew and I am a Samaritan. How come you are asking me for a drink?" That time, Jews do not associate with Samaritans. So just to give you a little bit of summary. Now, the Pharisees, they've heard that Jesus was baptizing and gaining a lot of disciples. Well, in reality, it was not Jesus, it was his disciples. Now, the John that was mentioned here is John the Baptist, the cousin of Jesus Christ, and at the same time, the one who prepared the way for the Messiah. Now, Jesus had to go through Samaria. Kailangan niyang dumaan sa Samaria. And in this Samaria, merong town na ang tawag is Sychar. And in Sychar, that is where the Jacob's well is located. Now, Jesus, of course, he was tired from the journey. Umupo siya doon. Umupo muna siya because it was about noon time as well. At the same time, sabi doon, Samaritan came to draw water. Now, Jesus, kinausap niya si Samaritan. He said, "Will you give me a drink?" Sabi ni Jesus to Samaritan. So the Samaritan was surprised. "How come you are talking to me? You are a Jew and I am a Samaritan. So why you are talking to me?" Now, to give you a little bit of a background and a context why Jews and Samaritan do not associate with each other is because long way back, history time, the kingdom of Israel, it was United Kingdom of Israel before, under the leadership of King Solomon, when he died, it fell apart. Now, this kingdom, it was divided into two. The two kingdoms were the northern kingdom, which is called Israel, and the southern kingdom, which is called Judah. Now, this northern kingdom, they live in the hilltop of Samaria. Doon sila sa hilltop ng Samaria. Now, in 722 BC, ang nangyari? In 722 BC, Assyrians took captive. Nilusob nila, kinangker nila yung northern kingdom. And then what happens, these Assyrians, they brought foreign people in the land. Now these foreign people, they are worshiping pagan idol. And then after that, these same foreign people, they entered into marriage with the Israelite. So what happened is, after they got married, the Israelites, they are worshiping the pagan idols alongside worshiping the God of Israel. So, dalawa yung sinamba nilang Diyos. Now, during that time, the southern kingdom, they remained racially and religiously Jewish. So, of course, they've come to know about what happened to northern kingdom. And then, they see them as what? Tainted, filtered, madumi na. Kasi nga, they worship the pagan idols. Now, because of this, they hated the Samaritans so much that they cannot see them eye to eye. That they opted a long way just by crossing the Jordan River para lang makaiwas, just to avoid Samaria. That's how they hated Samaritans. But in verse 4, what it says there, Jesus had to go through Samaria. Now, Jesus did the opposite of what a normal Jew would do. He went there personally, intentionally, not just that. He even, in verse 7, what happened? He spoke to her that even the Samaritan woman, she was surprised. How come you're talking to me? Why you're talking to me? Now, the same Samaritan woman who's outcasted by society, madumi ang tingin ng society sa kanya. But Jesus spoke to her. Now, what it means, Jesus is breaking barriers here. Jesus is what? Jesus is breaking the division of religion happening to Jews and the Samaritans. Amen? Now, Jesus, that's how he present himself to her, revealing himself to her, declaring himself to her that he is the Messiah. Now, what's the relevance today? How we can relate today? Aren't we acting like Jews and Samaritans sometimes? Where we are ready to fight for our religion, where we are ready and being defined by anong religion ka? Anong denomination ka? Right? Now, we forgot who's the main point. And that is Jesus. We are even walking on a path where we are ready to defend the religion of our ancestors. But where is Jesus? We forgot Jesus. So just like what he did to the Samaritan woman, he is offering personal relationship to you and I. But the question is, have we really genuinely accepted the personal relationship that Jesus is offering to us? Amen? Now, irregardless of what background she has, Jesus presented himself to her. Amen? Now, Jesus, he didn't come for religion. He came to have a relationship with you and I. Amen? That's the heart of Jesus. Now, let's move on to verse 10. Now, Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." "Sir," the woman said,
You have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where can you get this living water? Are you even greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did also his sons and his livestock? Now Jesus answered the Samaritan woman. He said, everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water, welling up to eternal life. Amen. Now, Jesus, he always has his own way to answer question. Remember when the Samaritan woman asked her, how come you are talking to me? He did not answer it directly. Now, even Samaritan woman said, you don't have nothing to fetch the water. So what would happen? How can you get this living water? Now, the living water that Jesus is mentioning in verse 13 is talking about the Holy Spirit, which is also found in John 7:38-39. It says there, whoever believes in me, as scripture has said, rivers of living water will flow from within them. By this, he meant the Spirit, whom those who believe in him were later to receive. Up to that time, the Spirit had not been given since Jesus had not yet been glorified. Now, in this verse, as we accept Jesus in our lives, living water from within will flow within us. Now, that's the Holy Spirit. Now, how you can have the living water if you don't have the source? And that source is Jesus Christ. That's why if we believe and accept Jesus in our lives, we would have that living water, and that is the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Now, the thing is, how come that the Samaritan woman was not able to fully understand, to fully get what Jesus Christ is saying? In verse 12, it says there, are you even greater than our father Jacob? To the point that she compares her ancestors to Jesus Christ. Now what's happening? She's too blinded by her tradition that she was not able to perceive what Jesus is offering her. Amen? Amen. Now in verse 15, let's continue reading. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water so that I won't get thirsty and have to keep coming here to draw water. Now she's tired. She's tired of going back to the well. He told her, go call your husband and come back. I have no husband, she replied. Jesus said to her, you are right when you say you have no husband. The fact is, you have had five husbands, and the man you now have is not your husband. What you have just said is quite true. Sir, the woman said, I can see that you are a prophet. Our ancestors worship on this mountain, but you Jews claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem. Now Jesus answered her, woman, Jesus replied, believe me, a time is coming when you will worship the Father neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. We worship what we do know, for salvation is from the Jews. Now, one of the few differences of Jews and the Samaritans is the place of worship. The Samaritans, they are worshiping in Mount Gerizim, while the Jews, they are worshiping in Jerusalem. So, isa yun sa mga differences nila. However, Jesus is not giving importance to the place of worship. That's what he said in verse 21. Jesus is highlighting here that what is important is the heart of worship and the one to whom you are worshiping. Amen? Yet a time is coming and has now come, sabi ni Jesus, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in the Spirit and in truth, for they are the kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is Spirit, and His worshipers must worship in the Spirit and in truth. And then the woman said, I know the Messiah called Christ is coming. When He comes, He will explain everything to us. Then Jesus declared, I, the one speaking to you, I am He. Wow, what a finale. Amen? Now, in the first initial verses, Jesus is declaring Himself to the Samaritan woman, yes? Now, after that, Jesus said, if you accept me, if you believe in me, you would have the living water. Now, this time, it's not just Him, but it's the Holy Spirit as well. Now, in John 3:3, it says, there Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Now, for us to be born again, the Holy Spirit that is from Jesus Christ, once we have that, once we have that born again, through the Holy Spirit, it will connect to God's Spirit, which will enable us to live a holy life. Amen? Now, being born again is not a church denomination. Being born again is to worship through the Holy Spirit, enabling us to live a holy life. In John 3, verses 5 to 6, Jesus answered, very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they are born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit. Now, since God is Spirit, we cannot connect to Him if the Spirit that we have is dead. Amen? Now, as Papi have mentioned, in his previous preaching, we inherited the dead spirit from Adam because of his disobedience to God's command. Now, because of that, our connection between God and humankind, it was stopped. Natigil siya because of that. And now, we cannot connect to God because we cannot worship because it was disconnected. But because of God's amazing grace, God's amazing love to His children, to the humankind, He gave us a way to be reconciled back to Him. And that is through Jesus. Amen. Now in John 3, verse 16, it says, therefore God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. Isn't that amazing? God gave us the way. We just have to accept that way, and that is Jesus. And it is only through Jesus that if we receive Him, we will have that born-again spirit, which will connect back to God. Amen? Now, what will happen if we have now the Holy Spirit? What will happen to us? Anong mangyayari sa atin? Now, He will give us wisdom when we read the Bible. Who can relate that before, it's so hard to read the Bible? Even myself, I cannot understand that. It was too deep. Sometimes, honestly, before, it makes me even sleepy because I couldn't understand it. But when we have the Holy Spirit, He will give us the wisdom. Hindi mo na namamalayan ang haba na pala ng chapter na nababasa mo. Amen? Now, when you have the wisdom of the Holy Spirit, you will see the truth. You will see God's plan in your life. You will see His heart through the Bible, through His Word. You will see what is in store for us, His children. Amen? And not just that, He will even convict us when we sin. Now, we will be more conscious of our sin. Example, ako before, de, malapit na yung red light. Ah, wala pa naman. So, naglalakad pa ako niyan. Wala pa naman. But now, you will be more conscious because you have to respect the law of the land. Amen? Even before, ang hilig kong magdala ng mga coupon band, mga office supplies. I thought it was normal before because everybody's doing it. So I thought, oh, it's okay. Everyone's doing it anyways. So I'll do the same thing. But now we've found out that what? It's a sin because it's stealing its company's property. Amen? That's the work of the Holy Spirit convicting you. Now, we will be more sensitive even to the needs of others. That before, you don't really mind, you just live your own life. Now, that's the work of the Holy Spirit starting to change in you. That's not good works. That's something else that even yourself, you will be surprised. This is not me before. Now, that's the work of the Holy Spirit. Amen? And even before, ang hilig natin mag-coloring. Kahit yung kasalanan natin, kinukulayan natin. May white lies. Hindi ko alam kung may green lies. Now, with God, in the eyes of God, it's just black and white. Right? If it's wrong, it's wrong. If it's correct, it's correct. There's no in between. Amen? Now, when we have the Holy Spirit, our perspective in life also is changing. Amen? Amen. Because that's the work of the Holy Spirit. Now, even before, I tried many times to change. On my own accord, I even planned the day. Bukas na lang, Lord. I even planned the day. Magbabago ako, magkakasala ulit. Magbabago na naman ako, mangangakong magbabago, magkakasala ulit. So, I even tried to tell to myself, it's okay, I'm going to church anyways. I'm washing my own sin. Checklist, I went to church today. Checklist, I did all this ministry work. Checklist, I give something to the poor. I even tried to go to different churches just for me to be able to find that change that I'm looking for. I thought being a member of a church would change me. I thought to be saved comes with the right method. But I found myself being stuck in a pattern, recurring pattern that goes back to sin. Because that's the spirit that is within me is dead in the first place. Now I know bakit hindi ko kayang magbago. Kasi nga patay yung espiritu na nandito sa loob natin. Not until when we accept Jesus. Now when I accepted, you know, I've been a Christian for a very long time. But I only met Jesus here in the UAE. And He's just too personal. He's just too intentional, just like what He did with the Samaritan woman. And because of Jesus and the Holy Spirit, I was able to understand more of the truth that is coming from His Word. Amen? Now, to worship in truth, through Jesus Christ, is enabling us to live and walk in truth. Now, in John 14:6, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So to worship in truth is to live and to walk just like Jesus did. To follow the commands of God no matter how hard it is. And it will be reflected in our lives if we are following the commands of God, if we are living a life. Christians, we are called to be Christ-like. We cannot choose comfort when Jesus himself was not comfortable when he was on earth. When Jesus himself chose to love the unlovable, even though no matter how hard it is, because that is the command of God. Amen? Living in truth is by having that full surrendered life to God. Not living according to what we know of what is right and wrong, but to live according to the truth of God. Amen? Now in Romans 12:1, therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. Now this is your true and proper worship. Now in summary, being born again is to worship through the Holy Spirit, enabling us to live a holy life. To worship in truth through Jesus Christ, enabling us to live and walk in truth. Amen? Now, in closing, true worship is a matter of the heart. It is an inner submission of oneself to God. True worship is worshiping in spirit and in truth, living a renewed life consistently with Jesus. Now, to maintain growth, we need spiritual food. So grow, go, grow, glow. But today, we'll just have grow. Kala nyo, ha? Next week na yung iba. Now, G, grow in the presence of God through prayer and spiritual family. R, read the Bible in all seasons. O, obey His commands. And W, walk a spirit-filled life. Amen? So after being born again, believers of Christ, what's next? What's in store for us after we have changed, after we have a renewed life? Share Jesus with compassion, just like how he was being compassionate with the Samaritan woman. Matthew 28:19-20, our greatest commission. Now for our memory verse, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Amen. Praise God. Much deeper within.
about you in everything that we do.